Right, I need to turn this down initially to 62mm diameter and a rough guess 16.8. If I take it down to 25mm in, that should be it for the moment. As a rough machining to start with. If I find the tools. These are old calipers that are just used mainly for scribing and taking rough measurements, so I'm just scribing a line that gives me something to aim for. Yes, incredibly cheap, out of Aldi about £7 I think these are, effectively disposable. I'm only taking off about just over half a millimetre off with every cut. I'm saying the motors aren't very powerful on this lathe and they're belt driven. You get a lot of belt slip if you really load it up. You can stall the belts basically. But it will get there. I'll come back once I've got that turned down. That's the first bit of the turning done. I've taken it down to 62mm and 26.8 in with a radius in the corner there, just a fairly tight corner on this, so that'll stop any cracks in there. Just used a little radius tool made of high speed steel. That's the smaller boss turn down. It's for a 1 3/8 bearing. Again, I put a radius on the inside corner just to relieve any stress there. So that gives me a hold on the 62mm diameter for machining the other face. I've still got one more step to put on this. The steps to take a sprocket which has got an internal diameter of 120mm. So I shall need to do that next. Thank you. down the outer diameter. I think I've got to take it down to 150 mm outside diameter. Just about 6 inches. I think 152, make it 6 inches exactly. We're getting. It's all about 2.25 millimeters to come off. To let it cool down a bit. And 120.6. It's very hot. Right, I shall let that cool down a bit before I do the final size on that one, because it needs to be a reasonable fit on this sprocket. Right, just opening up the bore a bit. I can only go so far in because I've got a bolt in the back. This side's not too critical on the bore, but from the back side I've got to put in a bronze bush, so it needs to be fairly tight tolerance. What size is it to be? 26.25. Taking out about a millimetre at a time, that's half a millimetre a side. So we're up to 20.25. Let's say it was 26.25. With the deflection and the tool post and tool and the slack gibs on my carriage, it tends to cut on the forward and the reverse, so you've got to watch that you don't go oversized by pulling the tool. That's claiming to be 26.3. Close enough. It's not a critical one, that side. Just a wee clearance. Just break the edge. Right, I've turned the workpiece round in the jaws and now clamping it on the 62mm diameter spigot that I turned. Because there's a chamfer or a radius in the corner, it's quite difficult to get it to seat down absolutely square. So what I've done, I've clocked it up in the with a clock gauge here, and that is not too bad at all. The wavering is just the surface finish, but if I turn it slowly enough, it's pretty much within a half a whatever. Is this in? This in thousands, yeah. So that should be good enough. Just back it out a wee bit. Sorry about that. Back you out a bit as well. That's looking pretty good. Just nip up all the jaws in case it decides to fly out at some inopportune moment. Still looking good. The wobble you can see here is, if you remember, I machined this back face with a right hand tool, and there's a difference of about, must be about 2mm difference in that point compared with that point. But that's all getting machined off anyway. But that face there is parallel to all the other faces on this side. They're all machined at the same time. Right, I've got the bronze bush in there. I've still to bore the bush to its final size. I'll do that after I take the rest of the counter bores out. So I'm now going in, well, I'm just roughing out, but for a 13.6mm bore by 106.4 wide. As you can see, it's showing minus 5.08. That's the fault that occurs in these. So I just need to re-zero it again and try. It claims to be 106.3. Oops, spring cut. Should take it out. Right, that's the bronze bush board. That's a nice snug fit on that. A bit of lubrication, that'll be fine. So the next thing to do is take it out of the chuck, and I've got to bore 6 mounting holes to bolt to the differential, and then 8 holes for the sprocket. Right, remember to put in the second counter bore here for the oil can, so the differential housing seats on that 106 diameter, and this 114 diameter the oil can seats in there with some polyurethane adhesive to seal it in. So that's it, ready to take out now and put in the rotary table and drill all the holes.